Hello, my name is Dr. Sarva Trizvi, and I'll be talking to you today about my paper titled Near-Infrared Quantum Dots for HER2 Localization and Imaging of Cancer Cells. For those of you who are new to quantum dots are fluorescent semiconductor nanocrystals of the size range of 2 to 10 nanometers with unique photophysical properties that enable a host of biomedical applications in medical and surgical oncology. The unique photophysical properties of quantum dots include a broad excitation spectra, a narrow symmetric emission spectra, high quantum yields, as well as high photostability. But what makes them very important for biomedical imaging is their property of multiplexed imaging, which means that quantum dots of a number of different colors can all be excited with a single wavelength of light, as well as size tunability, which means that quantum dots of the same nanomaterial can emit in a range of different colors, ranging all the way from blue to red and near-infrared wavelengths. Near-infrared emitting quantum dots are important for biomedical imaging because near-infrared rays between 700 to 1,000 nanometers can penetrate tissues without being scattered or absorbed, and this allows deep tissue visibility. The human epidermal growth factor receptor gene is overexpressed in between 25 to 30% breast cancers. We know that HER2 positive tumors are highly aggressive, show high recurrence and high mortality amongst newly diagnosed cases that do not receive systemic chemotherapy. Hence, the targeted blocking of HER2 receptors using the humanized monoclonal antibody has been shown to increase response rate, decrease the time for disease progression, as well as prolong survival. The current techniques for HER2 detection include immunohistochemistry, fluorescence in situ hybridization, as well as chromogen in situ hybridization. All these techniques are ex vivo methods of detection, and to date there's no available technique for an in vivo detection of HER2 status. Near-infrared imaging using quantum dots has been investigated for in vitro and in vivo imaging applications, and therefore in this particular project we aim to demonstrate the application of near-infrared quantum dots conjugated to anti-HER2 antibodies for targeted localization of HER2 receptors as one step prior to their in vivo application. The quantum dots used in this study are the core shell, cadmium telluride, cadmium selenide, zinc selenide, type 2, type 1 near-infrared emitting quantum dots that were synthesized at King's College London. We examined in this paper the in vitro toxicity of the quantum dots using three different cell lines, including the SKBR3, which is a breast cancer cell line that overexpresses HER2 receptors, the MCS7 breast cancer cell line that underexpresses HER2 receptors, and the HepG2 cells. We found that there was no evidence of toxicity to SKBR3 and MCF7 cells on exposure of 1 and 24 hours to a concentration of 60 micrograms per ml. There was evidence of minimal toxicity at 24 hours of exposure to HepG2 cells at concentrations of greater than 15 micrograms per ml. The quantum dots were conjugated to anti-HER2 antibodies using the EDC-NHS protocol, and the bioconjugate was purified and bioconjugation confirmed using FTIR. We then applied the QD antibody bioconjugate to both fixed and live SKBR3 and MCF7 cells in order to detect the HER2 surface receptors. We found that the QD antibody bioconjugate localized the HER2 receptors on the surface of SKBR3 cells, which was not evident on MCF7 cells. Based on these results, we concluded that NIR-QDs can be conjugated using the EDC-NHS protocol. The NIR-QD antibody bioconjugate can be used for rapid localization of HER2 receptors, and the NIR bioconjugate can potentially be used for targeted therapy as well as image-guided surgery. These novel probes can potentially be used for a number of other theranostic applications, for example in conjunction with carbon nanotubes for targeted photothermal ablation of cancer cells, as well as in conjunction with photoactive dyes for targeted photodynamic therapy. However, the clinical translation of these novel probes requires an in-depth analysis of their in vivo behavior and toxicity. Thank you.